Hello, my dear students. We are now starting with the third chapter that is called as Entrepreneurship Development. In this particular chapter, we will be learning about what is entrepreneurship and who exactly is an entrepreneur. Now, students, we all know that a person who undertakes any type of business activity is called as a businessman. But when a person starts a business activity which is very risky, or it is altogether a very new type of business which has never been done before, then that particular business activity is called as entrepreneurship. So entrepreneurship means the willingness of an individual to start a new business venture which involves a lot of risk. Now, because this is a new activity, you will find it very difficult to raise the capital. This person raises the capital. This person undertakes the production activity. Now, whatever are the factors of production required, he will bring them together. He will also create the market. He will find the customer. Now, this particular type of business activity is very difficult to do because we don't have any such major plans to execute it. क्योंकि ऐसा business तो पहला किसी ने किया ही नहीं है. तो ये businessman जो भी करेगा, खुद करेगा, अपने आप करेगा. Now, as I said, he will find it difficult to raise capital, but he will raise some of the capital. Now, from where to bring all the factors of production, जो raw materials लाने का है, कहाँ से लाने का है, इसको खुद को सोचना है. ये production कैसे होगा? पहले तो कभी ऐसा production हुआ नहीं है. इसलिए ये production कैसा होगा? इसको खुद को plan करना है. Then, the market is not aware about such a new product. So, he has to first think whether my product will be sold in the market. अगर yes है, तो ये कहाँ पे बिकेगा? इसका कोई कॉम्पिटिटर नहीं होगा, तो इसके लिए इसके पास कोई गाइडलाइंस नहीं है. व्हाट शुड बी द प्राइस ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट? नो सच एडवांटेज ही इज हैविंग. सो सच अ टाइप ऑफ बिजनेस एक्टिविटी इज कॉल्ड एज एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. एंड द पर्सन हु अंडरटेक्स सच अ टाइप ऑफ बिजनेस इज कॉल्ड एज एंटरप्रेन्योर. Okay, guys, now we are moving to the next thing, and that is called as the characteristics of entrepreneur. A person who undertakes this particular business activity is called as an entrepreneur. तो उसके क्या capabilities होने चाहिए, उसके क्या characteristics होने चाहिए. The first one, he should have intellectual capabilities. That means, in short, he should be a smart person. मैंने आपको पहले ही बोला था, ऐसा business पहला किसी ने किया नहीं है. तो इसके पास कोई guidelines नहीं है. जो भी करना है, ये बंदे को करना है. And that's why he should be a creative thinker. He should have some innovative ideas and he should have plans to implement those innovative ideas. So it requires a lot of thinking, it requires a lot of creativity, and that's why he need to have good intellectual capabilities. आगे ये प्रोडक्ट चलेगा नहीं चलेगा इसको पता नहीं है. So he should think about the future. Again, he should be thinking. So thinking is the process of the brain, and that's why intellectual capabilities are absolutely required by the person called as entrepreneur. Moving to the next point is called as future vision. Now, what do we understand by future vision? Future vision matlab aage ki soch. This type of business is altogether a new type of business. How such type of business will perform in the future? Iske baare mein usko sochna chahiye. He should adopt to the technology. Jo technology aaj hamare paas hai, usko kaise use karenge? Aur hum log aisa product banane ka hai, jo aage chalkar ya aage next generation bolo ya next years ke liye ye product should be successful. So all in all, he should be thinking a lot about the future, and so he should be futuristic. He should have a future vision. Then the next point is called as hard work. Now he is starting that business, जिसके बारे में किसी को भी पता नहीं है. ही नीड टू डू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. इन शॉर्ट, ही नीड टू वर्क फॉर लॉन्गर नंबर ऑफ आवर्स. जब कोई प्लान सेट होता है, जब अपने को पता है कि क्या होने वाला है, तो हम शॉर्ट में काम करके, स्मार्ट वर्क करके हम अपना काम को निपटा सकते हैं. बट वेन यू डोंट नो वॉट द फ्यूचर हैज इंस्टॉल्ड फॉर यू, देन यू हैव टू थिंक अबाउट ईच एंड एवरी possibilities, and that's why you need to work very very hard and very very long number of hours, and that's why hard work should be a essential feature of this person called as entrepreneur. Moving to the next point is called as technical knowledge. Now, what do we understand by technical knowledge? Technical knowledge is the knowledge about the technology. It's the knowledge about computers. Now, the future is all about technology. We know that. So, whenever he undertakes any type of production activity, marketing activity, how technology can help him? Ye technology ka help kaise le sakta hai? Iske upar usko sochna chahiye. And after thinking how to use the technology, he literally should have the technical knowledge. And if he does not have the technical knowledge, he should try and acquire that technical knowledge. So, for an entrepreneur, technical knowledge is a necessity. It is of utmost importance. Moving to the next point is called as communication skills. Now, what do we understand by communication skills? This particular businessman, an entrepreneur, has to deal with different types of people. We have said before that this is a new type of business activity. He won't get financed that easily. So, he need to have good communication skills to convince the investor that even though this is a new business, it will be successful in the future and I will be able to give you good returns. Aisa aapko investors ko कन्विंस करने को जमना चाहिए. उसके बाद इसके पास बहुत सारे सप्लायर्स हो सकते हैं या कम सप्लायर्स होंगे, तो सप्लायर्स को कन्विंस करना चाहिए टू गेट क्रेडिट. कुछ लोगों ने इसको लोन दिया होगा तो उनको कन्विंस करना चाहिए कि आई विल बी पेइंग यू ऑन टाइम. कस्टमर्स, नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट विल बी अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट, सो यू नीड टू कन्विंस द कस्टमर, यू नीड टू टॉक विद द कस्टमर्स एंड टेल देम हाउ दिस प्रोडक्ट विल बी यूजफुल फॉर देम. सो ऑल इन ऑल, ही नीड्स टू डील विद डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पीपल. And he needs to convince all these people. And for convincing, my dear students, we all know we need to have good communication skills. And that's why an entrepreneur needs best of the communication skills. He's also called as the fourth factor of production. Normal business mein land, capital, human resources, itna hi sab cheez lagta hai. Lekin entrepreneurship mein kuch to extra chahiye. And that extra is called as the fourth factor of production. So, one of that fourth factor could be called as the communication skills. Then he should be highly optimistic. Now, highly optimistic means you need to have a positive attitude towards your work and towards your life. Now, this particular business, as I told you, is a risky business. यहाँ पे risk बहुत ज़्यादा है, क्योंकि ऐसा business पहला किसी ने किया नहीं है, या near past में ऐसा business हुआ नहीं है. तो हमारा business successful होगा कि नहीं होगा, इसका कोई guarantee नहीं है. मैं तो बोलूँगा कि success के chances बहुत कम है, failure होगा. तो at the time of failure, he should not get a setback. He should not be demotivated. And this is the point of time. He should be highly optimistic. Wo apne aap ko bolna chahiye, no, nothing will happen. You can do it. Aapka future hamesha achha hi hoga. Aise soch ke saath wo aage badhna chahiye, wo try karte rehna chahiye. We have been saying try and try, but don't cry. And that is called as highly optimistic. Moving to the next one is called as he need to have the risk bearing capacity. Entrepreneurship is that business which involves a lot of risk. यहाँ पे risk तो होना ही है. क्यों risk होना है? क्योंकि ऐसा business पहला शायद किसी ने किया नहीं है. It's a very new type of a business or a new product or a new service that will be launched by the business. Now, ये product या service आगे चलकर successful होगा, इसका कोई guarantee नहीं है. आगे चलकर लॉसेस हो सकता है. अगर छोटा मोटा लॉस होता है तो ही शुड नॉट वाइंड अप. ही नीड टू हैव दैट सपोर्ट, मे बी अ फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट, एंड दैट इज रेफर्ड टू एज अ रिस्क बेयरिंग कैपेसिटी. सो एन एंटरप्रेन्योर नीड्स टू हैव रिस्क बेयरिंग कैपेसिटी. And the last point is self-confidence. Now guys, we all know कि self-confidence के सिवा कुछ भी नहीं हो सकता. अगर हम एक छोटा सा एग्जाम भी लिखने जा रहे हैं तो self-confidence के साथ जाना चाहिए. भाई यहाँ पर entrepreneur तो एक ऐसा business करने जा रहा है which is very new, which is a risky venture. And that's why he needs to have a lot of self-confidence. With this self-confidence, he can make impossible things possible. And these were the characteristics of an entrepreneur. Moving to the next question is, what are the characteristics of entrepreneurship? Now, after learning who is the entrepreneur and what are the characteristics of an entrepreneur, now we are trying to understand about the business that is called as entrepreneurship. Guys, in the introduction only, we have learned that entrepreneurship is starting a new business venture, which involves a lot of risk. So, this is the entrepreneurship type of business. Basically, it is a business, but it is a bit different. And what is that different? Let's try to understand through this particular question. That is, characteristics of entrepreneurship. The first one, entrepreneurship requires a lot of innovation. As we have said that entrepreneurship is altogether a new business activity. A lot of creative thinking is required in this particular business. What business is supposed to be started? Then what product is supposed to be made? Then what is the new production technique that we will be using? Because this is a new type of product, iska raw materials kya hoga aur ye raw material kahan se aayega? ये गुड्स को प्रोड्यूस करने के लिए क्या मुझे स्किल्ड लेबर मिलेगा, स्किल्ड वर्कफोर्स मिलेगा? और अगर मिलने वाला है तो वो कहां से मिलेगा, कैसे मिलेगा, कब मिलेगा, इसके बारे में मुझे सोचना है. नाउ द प्रोडक्ट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड, बट ये बिकेगा कहां पे? वेयर दिस प्रोडक्ट विल बी एग्जैक्टली सोल्ड? वेयर विल आई फाइंड दिस न्यू कंज्यूमर्स? ऑल सच टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू बी थॉट. And that's why I said that entrepreneurship is a innovative type of business. Everything that you'll be doing in this business will be new, never done before. And that's why innovation is the most important characteristics of entrepreneurship. Then, moving to the next one is called as, it's an economic activity. 11th standard mein padha tha, what is economic activity? Any activity which is done with the intention of making money is called as economic activity. So here, the entrepreneur also starts a new type of business to make money. He has to support his life. He has to live a proper standard of living. And that's why he starts a new activity. Now, my dear students, when he does this new business, he has to make profit. And the same profit will be utilized for the betterment of his business. That is, for the betterment of the product, for the betterment of the production process. And that's why entrepreneurship can be called as an economic activity. Moving to the next one, it is referred to as organization building. Now, every business requires different factors of production. मतलब अगर आपका specifically business manufacturing process वाला है, तो बहुत सारे factors of production लगेंगे. जैसे कि you require good capital, you require proper machinery, proper raw material, you will require land, you will require people who will be working for you. So, our entrepreneur has to bring together all these resources in an appropriate manner and in appropriate quantum. So, in short, he is building an organization. And moreover, this is a new business. So, whatever factors of production you require, you have to choose it very, very carefully. So, he will be using all his management skills. He will be listening to his heart and he will bring together all these factors of production. And that's how slowly and steadily he is building an organization. So, entrepreneurship is organization building. Moving to the next point is called as, it's a creative activity. Now, again, students, I am saying the same thing, that entrepreneurship means a new business activity. Shayad ye ek aisa business hai jo pehla kabhi hua nahi hai. To aapko bahut sara cheez jo sochna hai, wo out of the box sochna hai. ऐसा कुछ सोचना है जो पहला किसी ने भी सोचा नहीं है. तो यू हैव टू पुट अ लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेस ऑन योर ब्रेन. तुमको तुम्हारा ब्रेन का बहुत ज्यादा इस्तेमाल करना पड़ेगा. इट इज अबाउट थिंकिंग. Thinking about from where I will bring the raw materials because it's a new type of a product. ये product बनाने के लिए वो skilled workforce मैं कहाँ से लाऊंगा? Product बनने के बाद भी उसका tension खत्म नहीं होता. ये product बिकेगा कहाँ पे? अच्छा, because ये product पहले नहीं था, तो इसका pricing क्या होगा? इसका transportation मैं कैसे करूँगा? So all these new things are required to be thought very carefully, and hence entrepreneurship is a creative activity. Moving to the next one is he requires managerial skills and leadership. Again, I will be talking about the factors of production. ये सब factors of production को आपको जमा करने का है. मतलब उसके पास organizing का skills होना चाहिए. अच्छा, capital कितना लगेगा, raw material कौन से होंगे, ये सब उसको सोचना है. मतलब planning से इसको शुरुआत करना है. इसके पास skilled workforce का होना बहुत जरूरी है. तो ये staffing use करेगा. फिर ये स्किल्ड वर्कफोर्स को प्रॉपरली एक्सप्लेन करेगा कि ये मेरा बिजनेस क्या है, ये नया प्रोडक्ट क्या है, नया प्रोडक्ट कैसे बनेगा. मतलब ये डायरेक्शन देगा, अलग अलग डिपार्टमेंट्स, अलग अलग लोगों के बीच में प्रॉपर कोऑर्डिनेशन करेगा, एंड जो प्लान किया है वो हिसाब से लोगों को कंट्रोल करेगा. दैट मीन्स एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप इज ऑल अबाउट ब्रिंगिंग ऑल मैनेजेरियल स्किल्स टूगेदर. And an entrepreneur has to lead by an example. जो ये दूसरों को बताएगा, ये खुद उसको आना चाहिए. So he should be a very good leader. He should be a good communicator, a good motivator. So entrepreneurship involves managerial skills and leadership. Then moving to the next one is called as skillful management. Whatever are the resources of his business, that should be skillfully managed. अब that should be skillfully managed का मतलब होता है इसका wastage नहीं होना चाहिए, या हम इसको कैसे use करेंगे, इसका proper planning करके ही ये resources को use करना चाहिए. So all in all, skillful management is all about using the resources properly. Moving to the next point is called as risk bearing. The same old point. Entrepreneurship basically means starting a new business activity which involves a lot of risk. तो यहाँ पे risk bearing capabilities businessman के पास होना चाहिए. मतलब business में risk तो होना ही है. And the last one is called as gap filling function. Because it's a new type of business, बहुत सारे departments को पता ही नहीं होगा कि exactly हमको क्या standards को achieve करना है. तो यहाँ पे entrepreneur plays a very important role. जहां जहां पे जो जो deficiencies है, वहां पे entrepreneur खड़ा रहके वो deficiency को कम करेगा. मराठी में एक प्रोवर्ब है, कमी तिते आमी. That means जहां पे भी जो भी कम पड़ेगा, वहां पे entrepreneur जाके खड़ा रहेगा और वो deficiency, वो प्रॉब्लम को खत्म करेगा. That is called as the gap filling function. So with this, I have finished off with the characteristics of entrepreneurship and also the chapter of entrepreneurship development.